We are doing a mini band workout today. We're gonna focus on glutes and then throw some extra stuff in there just for fun. Everything's gonna be 40 seconds work, 20 seconds rest, and we're gonna run it through 3 times. I always recommend having 2 different size bands, a heavy one and a light one. Some exercises, you're not gonna feel anything with the light one. Other exercises, the heavy one is just gonna make it impossible. So it's good to have access to both so that you can switch it up as you go. Most likely your glute exercises will be good for your heavy band. And then your upper body exercises, you may wanna switch out for your light band. Okay, here we go. The lower you put it on your ankles, the harder it's gonna be. Keep one leg nice and stable, and the other leg is gonna step out in 3 different directions. Step out to the side, diagonally back, and then straight back. The leg that's on the ground is the one that is doing the work, so it's that stable leg that is gonna start to burn after a little while. Showing you a different angle here. These are step outs on the right side. That's your stance leg. You'll notice everything else is nice and stable, and we're just doing little tap outs with that left leg. This side was a lot harder for me, so you'll notice I start to slow down. Feel free to take this at your own pace. As we go into our pull parts, make sure that band is around your forearms and that your wrists and your elbows are in a straight line. You don't want your elbows flared out to the side, so keep them tucked in your side nice and tight. And this is going to start to burn really fast. So take your time. If you need to pause for a second, go ahead and then come back to it when you're ready. All right, going into our abductions. Again, band is gonna stay low around the ankles, and you're just gonna lift one leg up while grounding the other leg. As you get fatigued, your top leg is not going to lift up quite as high. It's gonna be just little tiny lifts, and that's okay. Just try and keep going. Time to go into your squats. You're gonna pull that band right above your knees. This is gonna be really hard and it might start to roll up a little bit. Try not to get frustrated. Just try and keep tension in between your legs. That'll hold the band in place. As you squat, think about pushing those knees apart and working against the band. It's gonna really turn on those glutes and the outside of your hip. I'd also recommend starting a little bit more narrow than you usually do in your squat. That way you have some room to push that band apart with just your knees and your external hip rotators. Going into your bent over row, you're gonna set up just like you did for your pull aparts, except you're going to hinge from the hips. Bring those arms straight down in front of your chest, and then you're gonna row up, keeping your elbows in close to your sides, keeping your back nice and active, and drive those elbows up behind you. Keep your forearms pushing away from each other. Watch how I'm setting up this tricep press. One hand will hold onto the top of the band, and the other hand is going to extend it down on the side of the tricep that you're working. And then just to help you out, you're going to hinge over slightly. Keep that elbow in close to your side and try and extend your arm as far back as you can. Make sure you have a good grip on that band. For your glute bridge with knee pries, band is going to be just above the knees. Holding in that glute bridge, you're going to pull those knees apart. Leave your feet facing forward. This one will also fatigue after a while, so your knee pries will just become a little bit less wide. That's totally fine. To transition into your dead bug, just push that band so it's over the top of the arch of your foot. Make sure your low back stays rooted to the ground. That is all you are concerned about. Don't worry about how far your legs come out, how low they are to the ground. You're just focusing on keeping that core nice and stable as you push out through that band. Nice job. Done with the first round, go ahead and rest for between 30 seconds and a minute. During my rest period, I realized that I needed a slightly lighter band for some of my upper body exercises. So I went and fished out a lighter green band in my equipment box. Setting up for round two. Get ready for those step outs. If you want, you can always switch which side you're starting with, just to keep things interesting.